I know what you're asking yourself. What's causing all this? He debuted in 1972 and was an active competitor through 2011. Widely regarded as the greatest of his profession, the Nature Boy captured over 40 world singles and tag team championships. His most notable accomplishment being a 16-time world heavyweight champion. A two-time member of the Hall of Fame, his name, moves, and catchphrases go hand in hand with professional wrestling. He's Ric Flair, and here's some items of his I've acquired. Started out with some trading cards. In 1991, Impel and WCW put out this very 90s looking set, and Rick had 12 cards in the set. I have three of them here, all in raw form, showing off a wide variety of colors of robes he had created. The backs don't look too different and not as 90s as the front. 1995 cards ending in a Z came up with the main event with WCW. This is Rick on a cameo appearance on Hulk Hogan's card, slapping on the figure four. This is a chromium WCW sticker. This is a bit shiny. I'm going to just do this real quick. The blank back. And apparently it's a tough one to find. I can't find much information. It was from 97. It's called chromium, and it's got, there's some shine to it. Giving you the four finger sign. 99 Topps Nitro. Looking very dapper. There's an embossed card of his from, I don't know if it's from this set, if it's a subset. I'll look into that one. Your basic information on the backs. In 2007, WWE put out their third series of Heritage, and you can find some of the packaging in this collector's tin. There were six different ones, and Rick had one. It's a 3D embossed photo that looks a bit similar, and it came with a tin bonus looking like 1980 Topps template, as well as the tin lid bonus called Champion, which reminds me of the Goodwin Champion design. He's one of six superstars to have this treatment in Heritage 3. To Be the Man, published by Simon & Schuster in 2004 through their Pocketbooks division, goes through Rick's childhood as an orphan, his college football career, introduction to the business, how he almost quit early on, plane crash in which he broke his back in a couple places, and how he persevered through a rigorous travel schedule, countless injuries, and a couple of marriages too. Some good color photos in the middle, lots of black and white ones throughout. And I had the pleasure of meeting Rick and having him sign this book when it was first released. To Be the Man. In 2003, WWE put out the Ultimate Collection DVD set. Three discs. This one was signed as well. Some great photos and a good treatment overall to the packaging and the way they laid out the matches in the menu. Has all your basic all-time great matches, featuring the likes of Sting, Barry Windham, Harley Race, and Dusty Rhodes, and even his Royal Rumble win in 92. Rick had another DVD collection released, the Definitive Collection, in 2008, just after his retirement from WWE and his Hall of Fame induction. And this comes with an in-depth interview to wrap up his career, along with lots of hidden treasure matches and promos. And it's also a three disc set. Last year I released a video of my wrestling autographs, not just Ric Flair's, in which I showed the ticket stub from meeting the Horsemen back in 1999 and the picture in which I got signed by all five members, J.J. Dillon, Ole and Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard, and Rick, all signed the composite. If you haven't checked out that video, I urge you to do so. You're going to love it. I'll put the link in the description below. From 1990 through 1994, WWF and Hasbro put out a 4-inch figure line of all their superstars. This is from 1993, and you can see Rick comes with a little punching action of his own. In 1994, he went back to WCW, and Toymakers came out with a 4.5-inch figure line. This looks like it's a rubberized Bendham type of action figure. But in 2007, WWE got serious, releasing the 7-inch in height Jax Pacific Unmatched Fury figure. What a great looking box. The windows, he's walking the aisle, he's ready to do his strut and say his famous catchphrase, and you all know what that is. Now those are all pretty common and easy to find collectibles, but now for that greatest wrestling piece I own that I teased in last year's autograph video. The one of one I'm teasing in this video's title. Rick appeared at a signing at the Times Square FYE in New York City prior to a December 2003 house show. I didn't attend the live wrestling event, but I did go to the signing, which was to promote his first DVD collection. And while standing in line, I noticed a production crew documenting the event for a TV show they had at the time called Confidential. Rick was wearing a wireless microphone, I noticed as I got closer to him, and someone may have been listening to our conversation, because when I was done, a producer pulled me aside and asked if I might want to be interviewed for possible inclusion in the package. So, well, let's let Mean Gene tell you the rest.
Did you get everything you wanted for Christmas? That might not be in the true spirit of the holiday, but it certainly is part of the fun of it. If you're a diehard wrestling fan, the ultimate Ric Flair DVD collection might have topped your wish list. What could be better than just the DVD? How about a signed copy? If you were really fortunate, you not only got the gift before the holiday, but you got a chance to meet the Nature Boy in New York City at his signing at the FYE store.
These are people that really enjoy wrestling.
Thank you very much.
Not just my DVD, but anything they spend when you start buying wrestling merchandise, they really truly are fans. And they, you know, I'm honored that they feel that way. The DVD isn't just about me. It's about some of the great wrestlers that, you know, I've performed over the years. It's not just Ric Flair, it's Dusty Rhodes and Ric Flair. It's Ric Flair and Sting. It's Barry Windham. It's Terry Funk. I mean, there's a lot of great people involved in it. And it really is kind of like a, no pun intended, the evolution of the business.
For those younger fans of the WWE today to look back and watch the Nature Boy really in his prime and the way the show and the program has evolved to what it is today. It's really fascinating to watch the evolution, if you will, of the programming, production values, and the way wrestlers are, you know, entertaining fans.
I never realized when I see some of these pictures how good looking I really was when I was younger. Gene Okerlund, you need to have me as your co-host on the show. That's what I want to do, not wrestle. I want to entertain with you, Gene.
So as you see, I made the cut, my out-of-style denim jacket included. And although they stole my clever evolution pun, damn them, I feel all in all it was a very successful television debut. So that's all for now. Thanks for hanging and banging. And, you know... You know, he does it so much better than I. See ya.